there's the lineup for the men's flying 200. Esterhazy of South Africa will start proceedings. Valakakis from Greece. And then we'll get to the highest ranked riders. Ed Dawkins from New Zealand. Dmitriev of Russia. Zhang Miao of China. Nakagawa of Japan. Shane Perkins. Robert Forsterman. Jason Kelly. And Gregory Bourget. Multiple world champion from France. Aiming for his first Olympic gold in the individual sprint. It all starts with a flying 200. And Team New Zealand, represented there by Ed Dawkins. Kevin Serow has the world record for the flying 200, 9.57. Chris Hoy, the Olympic record from 2008. Of course, he's the Olympic champion. Beat to Jason Kenny in the Olympic final, but to only one rider per nation for the men's sprint, as the rules have changed. It's a warm welcome this morning to my co-commentator Gerald de Kock. And Gerald, we've just had so much excitement over a couple of days of racing, and when the men's sprinters come on to play, it is action-packed indeed, isn't it?
It is. It's the big guns. You feel it's the, you know, the testosterone really does ooze out of the Velodrome, and there's an air of real excitement and tension as the riders start preparing. And again, we'll have a sellout crowd in here. And we've seen this track is lightning fast. They've moderated the temperatures to around 28 degrees. The atmosphere is perfectly set. It is cool around London today. There's no question that it's cooler. There was a heavy downpour of rain last night and early this morning, so outside conditions are quite cool, but everything inside, they keep the doors airlocked. There are two sets of doors coming in and out of the velodrome to try and maintain that air temperature, and the ushers are encouraged to keep it closed all the time. Well, out onto the track is a young man from South Africa, 19-year-old Bernard Esterhazy. What a big occasion it is for this young man. His ultimate goal is 2016 in Rio. But he's an immense talent, and someone that the South Africans are really hoping will deliver. Not necessarily today, but this is all part of the program, in a sense, they're looking towards Rio in 2016. He's been attending the UCI's World Cycling Academy in Switzerland and learning huge amount, former world junior champion, so a lot of talent and a huge experience for him.
It was in the kilometre, so he can stretch that speed. This is all about getting the angles right leading into the timing mechanism. When they start the 200 metres, they'll go very high on the track and swoop down the track to get maximum momentum. So there's an art to the flying 200. Kevin Serow, the flying Frenchman, has the world record, 9.572, set in Moscow a few years back now.
There's the bell for Bernard Esterhazy, and he hits the sprint line and goes now. And he'll be cheered along. Always good to go out first here. Everyone's expecting. And young South African Bernard Esterhazy, 10.350, sets the first marker.
Perhaps could have been a bit steeper into that timing mechanism to start the flying lap. But as you mentioned, Gerald, all a learning experience for this young man, just 19 years of age. And here's Valakakis of Greece, 23-year-old, 13th in the team sprint at the 2010 World Championships. A prestigious Moscow Kieran last year. Well, he'll be looking to get around that 10-second mark. 10.35 by Esterhazy of South Africa. Spectacular strip from Greece. The electric blue. He's trying to conserve the energy, top of the track. And now he's going to wind up that big gear. And it's all about power and executing your power. Here he goes. Let's see how high he stays on the track. 10.3. He's gone down pretty low. The clock starts at that point. Remember, it tracks for 250 metres. So we're looking at Volokakis of Greece. The time to beat 10.35, and that's 10.663 outside of the South African's time.
Yeah, as we go along, we'll learn exactly how good each of these marks is, but obviously, when we get down to the business end of only 17 riders here, likes of Perkins and Fosterman and Kenny and Gregory Bourget. And we'll see the times really get close to sub 10 seconds. Pavel Kellerman is from the Czech Republic.
More known as a Kieran rider, third in the prestigious Kieran event in Germany, Cologne. You can see his physique a lot more slighter than some of the other sprinters who are just so bulked up in the top half of the body and got the bulging legs. He's a little bit more fine, more of a kilo type of physique. Pavel Kellerman of the Czech Republic, looking at that time of around about 10.35, and it's 10.311, so he's under Esterhuizen's time from South Africa, and he's the fastest so far after three riders.
Getting the angles right and timing this track at 42 degrees. On the bends, and again maximizing the conditions as Spaniard Jorge Zacuaren Uria is on the track.
National Kieran champion, second in the sprint. Spanish aren't known to produce outstanding sprint riders on the track, but they have placed more resources behind their track racing. This Masters of the Road. There's Kieran of Spain, 23 years of age, winding up the machine. He hits the mark now. 10.311 the time to beat, and he's had some issues.
Oh, he's had some issues.
Massive issues, and that's not going to be a time that will carry him to any sort of ranking as he limps across the line. 11.2. 794, so he's had a problem with the bike. In fact, the seat's come off. A bracket holding the seat, I think. There it is, there's the seat. And that's a real shame. But there is a rule, we saw that in the men's team sprint with Philip Hines. The seat just coming off and the bracket exploding under the seat, holding it onto the frame of the bike. Just explain your take on Philip Hines in the team sprint, because he did go sideways, his foot came out of the pedal, and there's a rule that says that if a mechanical failure on the bike, they can have a restart.
Well, that's exactly what they did, but he then came out afterwards and said that he did it on purpose. He knew he would get a restart if you watch the replay, it did look strange. It looked a little odd as he went down in a heap. This is the American Jimmy Watkins.
He's got the national record at 9.87, so he's capable to go under the 10-second mark. The 29-year-old from California, Jimmy Watkins, ripping into the bike. Let's see if he can set a time under 10 seconds. 10.247. Average speed of 70 kilometres an hour, so you'd be booked if you're in a car at that speed in many parts of this great city of London.
Watkins is topping the table now, so we're seeing the pecking order slowly but surely sorting itself out. Watkins, Kellerman, the Czech Republic, but really bad luck for the Spaniard Uria.
Here's Damian Zielinski. He's been a good all-round cyclist, European Omnium champion back in 2004, 30 years of age now. 10th in qualifying the Poles in the team sprint. They would have been disappointed with that performance. and he's raced the individual sprint once at World Championship level, finishing 23rd. So in the veteran class now, Zielinski. Let's see if he can put the foot on the pedal and produce some speed. 10.247 is across the line, ripping into the bike. Trying to get maximum speed out of the machine. Let's see if he can post the time under that mark. 10.323 has him in third place currently.
Well, he went at 10.192 in the World Championships at Melbourne. So he'll be a bit disappointed with that. A pole, which puts him in third place at the moment. Now from Trinidad and Tobago, Nicholas Phillip.
Third in the Pan American Sprint Championships. Trinidad and Tobago, known for producing their sprinters on the track and track and field, and also some terrific cricketers over the years. Track cycling, not a big sport there. Trying to work the track every angle. Going high and produce maximum effort when they cross that line to start the 200 metre timing mechanism. Sweeps down the track, and it's a good angle into that line. Let's see how he can go. From Trinidad and Tobago, Phillip.
Got great support around the stadium, and Nicholas Phillip comes in very impressively, and he's got the fastest time, 0.045.
10.202. So that's a very good effort. Again, he's not a hulking figure when you compare him to some of the biggest sprinters in this field. Used the bike well, good technique.
Leaving nothing behind. Absolutely everything here. It's the first round of qualification to determine a ranking, and then into knockout rounds after this.
Canon from Venezuela. Pretty useful in qualifying at the World Championships. 10.077. Venezuela has got a useful track program. Starts now, good line into the back straight, dips ahead, ripping into the machine, just outside the sprinter's line, a little bit ragged into that turn, but he's producing maximum effort, 10.123, it's a useful time, not as quick as Melbourne, but it ranks him number one at the moment.
Yeah, 10.077 in Melbourne. Shake of the head, he's not entirely happy yet, got a bit of ragged around here, and all over the bike, wrestling with it to get absolutely everything he could out of it. Anthony Canelon. And he's top of the pile just for the moment. Rider number eight from Malaysia, Aziz Awang.
Aziz Hasni Awang. And he's famous for that shear of the track that pierced his leg back in 2011 at the National Track Centre in Manchester at a World Cup meeting, in a Kieran won by Chris Hoy. Made headlines all over the world, but he's a very useful sprinter. Coached by John Beasley, does a lot of his training in Melbourne.
10.193 in Melbourne at the World Champs. Just failed to qualify.
Virtual home track for him. So here's Awang from Malaysia. Can go low tens. It's 10.226. So he'd be a little bit disappointed with that. He's gone around the 10.1 mark in the past. Malaysians have really improved their sprint stocks in the last 5 years under John Beasley, former Australian junior coach.
Put Awang at the moment as the third quickest behind Canelon and Philip of Trinidad and Tobago.
Here's Ed Dawkins from Invercargill, 23 years of age, world junior kilo silver medalist. He's been a very consistent sprinter. And they were fifth in the team sprint, edged out by France in the first round after qualifying seventh. Of course, the silver medalist and a bronze medalist at the world titles in the team sprint. So he's a very, very accomplished young sprinter, Ed Dawkins.
Could see the first sub 10-second lap here.
Good line into the turn. He's keeping his composure. Has he got the speed? It's 10.201. Ranked second at the moment.
The ranked in qualifying at Melbourne in 9.953. Again, it's all relative to conditions out there today and whether we'll be able to assess the riders' performances once everyone's done their qualifying, of course.
Interestingly, 10 riders went under that 10-second mark in Melbourne for qualifying. It was a pretty hot day at the boards at the Vodafone Arena. And here's Denis Dmitriev of Russia.
At the World Champs, he finished 30th, 10.209.
Russian sprint champion, going high. More noted for their distance riders on the track and the team's pursuit and the point score. And he sweeps into the line and goes a little bit high down the back straight, trying to get the roll off the transition, which he does. And let's see if he can. Under 10 seconds, no, 10.088, but it's a quick time. At the moment, he's number one in the rankings.
Well, the Russians are putting an enormous amount of financial and effort into their track program, and it's starting to look as though they're paying some dividends. Dmitriev, quickest at the moment, 10.088.
Is a rich benefactor that certainly added to their financial coffers. That's exactly why Heiko Salzwedel is there, the famed coach. And here's Zhang Miao, 23 years of age, fourth in the World Championships at the team sprint in 2010 at the World Titles, fifth at the Olympic Games, of course, sixth in the kilo at world title level, and has been 15th in the sprint. He's a pretty consistent fast man on the bike. Of course, Daniel Morlon, the former Olympic champion, world champion, is the man guiding the Chinese program. He finished a close second in the women's team sprint, so he's definitely looking to go under 10 seconds.
10.061 at Melbourne in qualifying in 14th place.
Zhang stops the clock just beyond the 10-second mark, 10.155.
It's in third place. And Dmitriev and Canelon.
Of course, China have already won two silver medals. One controversially in the women's team sprint when they were relegated after being first across the line in the final. And then Gong won the silver in an exciting women's Kieran last night. Here is Toshisho Nakagawa of Japan, eighth in the team sprint, 33 years of age. So one of the older riders out there. You know, the Japanese have a professional Kieran series, very popular in that country.
He's the first of the riders to just miss out on sub 10 seconds in Melbourne and qualifying. Let's see how he goes here at the Olympics. Drops down quite high still. Off the bend now. And not quite under 10. He puts him in third place at 10.144. 0.56 behind the leading time at the moment, Denis Dimitriev. Wrestling with it. Every ounce of effort goes into this qualifying. It's brutal.
That was the shot previously of Mascaron of Spain, having his seat explode beneath him, and he gets a rerun, which is a very good decision. Modicoma says, of course, a mechanical meant that he could not complete his laps adequately.
He's a big man, and it's all getting the balance right, isn't it, between maximizing the weight, minimizing the weight of the bike, and maximizing strength. Here he goes.
Second in his national sprint title, Kieran champion of his country. He's 23 years of age, so still learning on the bike. Tall and strong man down the back straight, trying to get maximum effort. The time to beat 10.088 set by Dmitriev of Russia. I don't think he's going to be under that time. 10.604 has him ranked in 12th place.
Which at this stage is not going to do him much good in terms of direct qualification. He's second last. But at least he's got his lap in after the subtle explosion that derailed his first lap.
It is day three. We're looking at the men's sprinters, and we're looking at Shane Perkins, former Kieran World Champion back in 2011, current Commonwealth Games Sprint Champion. Australia narrowly missed out in the bronze medal to Germany in the men's team sprint. That would have been a bit of disappointment. He missed out on selection in 2008 after a struggle with Ryan Bailey, the hero of 2004 in Athens for Australia. But he's a powerful sprinter. Whether he's in the sub 10 second form, we'll soon find out. He's capable of producing a time 10.9965 at the World Championships in Melbourne, in his home track. So we're looking at Shane Perkins. Starts the timing mechanism. A big man. And he's rapidly ripping into his machine as he swings into the front straight. Will he go under 10 seconds? He does. 9.987. The first man to do so in the flying 200.
That was a quick lap. He really got the start going well. And off the bend very smoothly. Shane Perkins, the first sub 10 second lap here. 9.987. 25-year-old will be well pleased with that. He's holding it together.
The Australians had a training camp in Matachiari in France before the Olympic Games, but they'll be disappointed with their showing overall so far. Here's Robert Forsterman, who picked Australia for that bronze medal in the team sprint. World champion in 2010 with Max Levy and Stefan Niepke in the team sprint. Down to ride the mountain bike, so a little bit of a controversial one that
yeah.
One.
It's not uncommon here, as we've seen. Mikhail Bourguin was signed up to ride the road race just at 3 kilometres and dropped out because he's a sprinter on the track. And Forsterman only got into this because he entered into the mountain bike. Here he goes. Second fastest in qualifying at the World Championships behind Bourguin at 9.873.
There's a big man, Robert Forsterman. Can he get the maximum out of his machine? Goes very high there. 10.072. I think he got his lines wrong. Sometimes when they get the run off the bend and they lose time if they go high on the track, which happened there with the German.
He's just immensely powerful, isn't he? He certainly won't be taking his mountain bike too far around the laps at Hadley Farm on the last weekend of the Olympic Games.
And the big roar is for Jason Kenny, the Olympic silver medalist, multiple junior world champion, silver behind Chris Hoy in the final in Beijing. He won the 2011 World Sprint Crown after Gregory Bourget was first across the line, but was then disqualified for missing three drug tests in that year. So Jason Kenny, the 24-year-old, already Olympic champion in the team sprint. The British fans rise as one. He should go under 10 seconds. The time to beat 9.987 set by Shane Perkins. Here's Jason Kenny, very neat lines. He'll go under 10 seconds.
Brilliant.
9.713, a new Olympic record. That is very quick.
Brilliant, brilliant ride. So smooth. He got absolutely everything right there. Going into the corner, there was none of the bike movement that we've seen from the other riders. He's got it spot on here, Jason Kenny. Silver medalist at the World Championships. And he clocked a blistering time here of 9.713, which is quicker, in fact, than his qualifying time at the World Champs, where he got the silver medal. Brilliant.
Yet more celebration for Team GB. Here's Gregory Bourget. He's won 6 world titles. 4 years in a row he was crowned the world champion in the sprint, but had one taken off him. Helped France win team sprint silver behind Britain at the Beijing Olympics, and a similar story here in London.
And here goes Bourget, the 27-year-old four-time world champion. 9.854 at the World Champs in qualifying. Can he beat Kenny's Olympic record?
So Bourget, again, pretty neat on the bike. He's going to have to be flying to beat Jason Kenny's time, and it's 9.952. And you're absolutely spot on. Kenny, technically, for that flying 200, it was like he was on rails. Incredible ride. 9.713. Bourget was quick, but Kenny, in sprinting terms, was so much quicker.
And the smoothness with which Kenny came around the bend there. Bourget's not far off it either, must be said, but that's the difference. See, at the sharp end of the sprint here, Kenny, Bourget, Shane Perkins, the only three sub-10-second riders, but very smooth. Wrestling with the bike, going side to side. We saw it from some of the early riders, the bigger men. Tends to negate straight line speed. So there it is, the first session of sprint qualifying. Jason Kenny, only three sub-10-second riders.
0.2 of a second quicker than Bourget. Perkins third, Forsterman fourth. And there we go, down the list. The last place rider for the carcass of Greece. But not lightning quick conditions, only three riders under the magic 10-second mark. It was qualifying for the men's sprint.